for breast cancer,
if you have health insurance, it doesn't cover. So I told my nurse that I wanted to take medicine and die because I can't take it. The way
Wait, you wanted to kill yourself?
Yes. So I just said that maybe if I end it, my husband will use that money to take care of my children.
So I was lying down. For my son, he liked playing with me. So when he came, I was just lying on my chest, just pressing around my breast, and I was just even asking him to stop. But unfortunately, he was just saying, "Mom, there's something hard there." I said, "Ah, what are you talking about?" "Mommy, see, touch it." So when I touched it and I felt there was something hard, my son is 8 years. Yes. So the following morning, when I go to work, I have to report it. And the doctor to check. Then he asked me to go for a scan.
1 in 8 women are diagnosed with breast cancer in Ghana. It is the leading cause of cancer mortality among Ghanaian women. In the northern region, there's just one referral center that takes care of the high number of cases reported, the Tamale Teaching Hospital. Today, I am at the Tamale Teaching Hospital. I'm going in there to speak with the health professionals and the patients to examine the extent of the problem. Breast cancer is the leading cause of cancer-related deaths in Ghanaian women. The Global Cancer Observatory estimates 16,600 cases of cancer occur annually in Ghana. Cancer.org defines breast cancer as a cancer that forms in the cells of the breast. Breast cancer can occur in women and rarely in men. Symptoms of the disease include a lump in the breast, bloody discharge from the nipple, and changes in the shape or texture of the nipple or breast. Treatment depends on the stage of cancer. It may consist of chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery.
I noticed lumps in my stomach, my armpit, and my breast, so I went to the hospital. Since I came to the Tamale Teaching Hospital, my condition has improved.
Before October, I was feeling some bulky, this thing, just above my breast. So of late, I'm feeling some pains, and it's coming closer to my chest. So I decided to come. Yesterday, I consulted one nurse, and he told me it's free, so I can come around.
When you come very early, whereby the cancer is only limited to the breast, that is a very good thing for us. We are always so happy to receive those clients. But there are instances when someone arrives, there is already a big ulcer on the person's breast. The entire arm is swollen. Some of them even get here breathless because the cancer has gone all the way to the lungs and the chest and they can't breathe. Some come with abdominal distension. Some people, the first time they get it, they're already having an epileptic fit, a seizure, because of cancer has gone to the brain.
The breast cancer has a tendency of spreading to other parts of the body, i.e. the brain, the spine, the lungs, the pelvic bones, and you know, sometimes the ovaries and the rest. So this woman that you saw, her cancer has already spread to the spine and to the pelvic bone, according to the investigation that we did. So that is why she can walk. In fact, she's having what we call pathological fracture. Depending on the site that the cancer will spread to, you will see the manifestations. For instance, if the cancer spread to the brain, the patient at that time becomes very confused. What we call amnesia, you tell the person something, he forgets. Sometimes they can vomit, and sometimes they feel restless and severe headache. It gives indication that it has spread to the brain, and then you go ahead and do investigation. When it gets to the spine, like this woman, mostly down, call it the lumbosacral part, down, getting to the waist, it can make them paralyzed. So as you see that woman sitting in the wheelchair, her condition is a result of the fact that the cancer has spread to the spine.
The Tamale Teaching Hospital serves as a referral center for all 5 northern regions: the Upper East Region, Upper West, Savannah, Northern Region, and Northeast Region. For breast cancer, the hospital screens over 300 women monthly and up to 3,000 during awareness months.
We see in the range of 250 to 300 cases in total of all breast cases. And from these cases, I expect to 70 to 80% are really breast cancers. So the numbers are really huge. But that is not what is most devastating. It's about the advanced stage when they report. That is always the most devastating aspect of it.
Somewhere last year, October, we thought maybe we even cross our target, but we went beyond the target. So it means that women are becoming aware of the condition. So anytime they hear the screening, they come in their numbers.
Breast cancer is real and it's not spiritual like others think. When we detect cases, we refer them to the hospital, to the breast clinic at the Tamale Teaching Hospital, and they are seen there for further management.
Many of the women who walk through the doors of the hospital are from surrounding regions and villages. For oncology nurse specialist Evelyn Ose-Amo and her colleagues, although they go the extra mile for their patients, their efforts are shortchanged by the lack of resources to treat the disease.
Part of the treatment of breast cancer is radiotherapy, X-ray treatment. See, we have surgery, we have X-ray treatment, we call radiotherapy, then we have chemo, which is drugs into your veins, then we have immunotherapy. The second one, which is radiotherapy, we don't have a machine in northern Ghana. All the five northern regions, we don't have it. So we have to send the patient to Kumasi, which is the nearest place. And that costs a lot. They may have to stay there for 1 month. So majority of patients, we are not able to send them to Kumasi, meaning that the treatment is short. It is not a full treatment, which affects your survival.
Some of the things, investigative equipment are not there. Aside that, it's not in the hospital, it's not found in the region. Upper East, Upper West, Savannah, no, unless so some of them like mammogram, unless Kumasi or Accra. So those are some of the things that brings some challenges. Sometimes you give some treatment and you want to do some investigation to see the progress and you can't get it unless the patient travels to Kumasi or Accra. So sometimes investigation like echocardiogram to check the heart. So you give someone the treatment and you want to see whether the heart is fine before you can continue or not, and you can't get it.
As far back as 2010, cases of breast cancer were coming to the hospital. I actually got involved somewhere in 2013. Those days we were really handicapped when it comes to managing the breast cancer. So as soon as we picked up the case, we want to refer the case to either Confanochi or Kolibu. And I remember most of the time, a woman will look at you and tell you they don't even have the money to travel. So they will prefer to go back home and die. But then I can say that for as the years goes by, I think we have really, really moved ahead. Our women can come here when they are even being referred to the other northern regions, to Tamale. We are able to diagnose them, going through all the necessary tests, have the radiotherapy machine here. So no matter how we move, we get to that point and we are stuck. So you will have to talk to this patient to be referred to either Confanochi or Kolibu.
Beyond the lack of equipment and drugs, there's the constant problem of poverty and ignorance.
Breast cancer, the survival depends on how early you come. If you come when the lump is small, we say stage one, stage two, your chances of survival are great. If you come and the stage is three, four, even though we treat you, survival is quite short. The next thing is biopsy. To diagnose breast cancer, you need to do something called biopsy. Now, we have a doctor who is doing the biopsies for us, but the costs is sometimes difficult for patients and they can't pay. And even the biopsy, there is something called IHC. That makes the price higher. And most patients cannot pay for the biopsy plus IHC. IHC means
immunohistochemistry of the cancer. Okay, this is a big term, but we do this and they cannot pay. So we just want to have some help from anybody who will help us maybe fund half of this for the poor women so that we can do a lot of biopsies. Without biopsies, you can't treat breast cancer.
When you finish with the medication which you are giving to the patient, what we call the chemotherapy, it means the patient has to be moved over there at a time frame. So the fact that they have to organize and mobilize money brings about so many delays. And you know, recurrence are actually very high. Mm. So this means that before they can organize money to get to Kumasi for radiotherapy, then the situation can actually
sometimes
get
it's too late.
So there is really so much negative impact on this particular aspect.
When these women have a support system and some education, the burden is lessened. Ruth is one of the few women whose husbands support them in fighting the disease.
Everywhere I go, I thank God. First, I thank God, and the second is my husband. If my husband is not there, or if I don't have a caring husband, I could have died by this time.
So he was your support system?
Yes, my husband supports me anything. Money, prayers, encouragement, my children, everything, my husband.
But for everyone, Ruth, there are 1,000 other women whose husbands and family abandon them as the disease progresses.
I don't know it. I know it. And the Nikununu, with my self, Pesa, Minuna, Dana.
The medication makes me weak. I am a sick woman. My husband tries to have sex with me sometimes, but I am too weak for that. Because I declined, he packed his bags and went to live with his other wife. I pay for the hospital bills by selling cocoa.
As they fight this disease, for which time is critical in determining a life or death outcome, staff of the Tamale Teaching Hospital continue to hope for days when the hospital will have enough equipment to mitigate the damage created by breast cancer. Long for long, MX24, Tamale.